Hey guys, Sam Pardee here. I'm going to be recording another Cube Draft for Channel Fireball. So we have an interesting pack here. None of these cards really jump out at me as super powerful, or at least super high above the curve. They're all super powerful because it's Cube. I don't know how good Jace Architect of Thought is. I have not drafted that guy before. But he's a Planeswalker, so he's got to be pretty good. It's usually a very powerful permanent type. So he's really good, or he, I assume, is really good. Genesis Wave is one of the best ramp spells, I think, just because it usually ends the game when you cast it, as opposed to some of the other ones where they can, like, still burn you out or whatever. Usually Genesis Wave puts enough stuff into play that you can either kill them that turn, destroy a bunch of their lands, or gain enough life to sort of be out of range of whatever could be going on. I think I'm just going to take the Jace, though. It's the only blue card in the pack. The other cards I could consider are the mono-red cards. I think Lightning Mauler is a little better than Hell's Thunder, but Jace seems more interesting than that, so we're going to grab him. Alright, we have Rolling Earthquake, which is a great sweeper in any control deck, because it kills all the creatures and also like an opposing Planeswalker, which is just awesome. You take some damage, but it's not the end of the world. So that card's very good. Serendib Efreet is just fine. Some fetch lands, both would go fine. I would take Scalding Tarn if I was going to take a land out of this pack. Apocrysite is also pretty good. I think I'm going to go with the Rolling Earthquake, though. It's the card that excites me the most out of this pack. Alright. So, we have Desperate Raven, Porcelain Legionnaire is okay, Coral Helm Commander, man, this is kind of slim pickings. I don't, like, it's not even that I feel like this pack is good for anyone. I don't think, like, Glorious Anthem, Life from the Loam, Troll Ascetic, Naturalize, or Beast Within are even particularly good cards, so I don't feel like we're just, you know, in the wrong archetype or anything. I think this is just kind of a weak pack. I'm going to go ahead and take the Desperate Ravings. I think it can be good in sort of a slower blue-red deck. Alright, so here we have Ponder, Magma Jet, Flooded Grove I could see. Survival is powerful, but I think it's not actually as good as people think it is. It takes quite a lot of work. You have to have graveyard shenanigans, I think, basically, to make it good. Just playing it sort of as a fair card. I mean, it's good, but it's not that unfair. I think I just want to take Ponder. Increase our consistency. Magma Jet's good also, but Ponder is Ponder. Ooh. So we have Tundra, Izzet Charm, Bogarden Hellkite, and Koth. Bogarden Hellkite is not actually interesting to me. It's too expensive and too replaceable of an effect. Izzet Charm is okay, but I think it will probably wheel just because there aren't a lot of people interested in that. I think I'm going to go ahead and grab Tundra. Gives us just a lot more options down the road. Wildfire is very powerful, but I don't think it's very good in the Magic Online cube just because there's not a lot of ways to get enough of the artifact mana to really make it work. Although, so far, we have a deck that's actually pretty good for it. The other options are Armageddon, which is, like, obviously a very powerful card, but doesn't fit with the other cards we have so far. Kira is just fine, but not spectacular unless you're sort of aggressive. Well, we could still end up being aggressively slanted. I think I'm going to take Wildfire and try and do something different. Alright, so we have Spreading Seas, which is actually pretty good. Talrand, Seaside Citadel, and Bloodstained Mire. I think I'm going to go ahead and take the Bloodstained Mire. It lets us splash more colors, potentially. When in doubt, when I sort of have picks that I consider sort of lower on the power level, I like to just take the land because you're going to end up with 23 good cards almost no matter what. And if you have enough lands, you'll be able to take better cards later in the pack. Like, now this Terminate feels kind of open to us because we could potentially be splashing black. But I do want Sphinx of Dwar'el. It's a consistent, powerful finisher, goes well with Wildfire, and blocks like a champ the turn it comes down. Alright. I'm kind of surprised both Lightning Mauler and Hell's Thunder wield. But I don't think that's really what we're interested in, although we're clearly not interested in Brushland. I'm going to go ahead and take Lightning Mauler. I guess we could still end up as like a blue-red tempo deck, and Lightning Mauler is pretty good there. Alright, so we have Serendib. Phyrexian Revoker is okay. I think I'm just going to take the Serendib, though. I've heard sort of some people who are down on this card, but I actually kind of like it. Even against the aggressive decks, it usually gains you a bunch of life because they can't just attack through it. It's so big. And against the controlling decks, it lets you apply a lot of pressure. I'm going to take the Bounce Land here. Molten Rain is also acceptable if we ended up as an aggressive blue-red deck. But I think it's more likely that we're going to be a controlling deck with the Jace and the Sphinx. Maybe Boros Charm if we end up splashing red. Yeah, I guess we'll take Boros Charm. It's Flint of Bor. No, I'll take the Flooded Grove. Maybe we end up like Rug or something. All right, Izzet Charm came back, just like I was hoping. Phantasmal Bear would also be respectable to go with our early aggressive creatures, but I think Izzet Charm is going to be better. Just because it's a little more flexible. Like it'll play well in an aggressive deck and a defensive deck. So I'm happier to have that. Alright, Yavimaya Coast shores up a potential green splash if we want it. And Lion's Eye Diamond, 15th pick as always. Alrighty then. So we have Stoneforge Mystic, who is absurdly powerful. Although we don't have any equipment yet, it would just basically give us carte blanche to pick any equipment. And the rest of this pack is pretty uninspiring for us. I think Sylvan Library would be okay. Like Pillager Avalanche Riders would be acceptable, but I'm not excited about either of them. And the power level on Stoneforge Mystic is just so high. So it does make us sort of want to bias more towards some white fixing and obviously pick up an equipment, but I think it's worth it. So we have Essence Scatter, Snapcaster, Cryptic. Snapcaster or Cryptic are basically our the two options in my mind. Essence Scatter is just weaker than both of those. I think. And then hopefully we'll wheel either Flooded Strand or Clifftop Retreat is the idea. To shore up our white splash. I think I want to take Cryptic. Yeah. This is a really tough one. Snapcaster's clearly very, very good. But so is Cryptic. I'm going to take Cryptic. It's a little less restrictive on how your deck has to be built. Alright, so here we have Into the Royal, Izzet Boilerworks, and Huntmaster, because we do have these two green sources already. I think I'm going to go ahead and grab the Huntmaster, and probably we'll wheel the Izzet Boilerworks, and possibly we'll wheel Into the Royal, and I would be fine with either. Alright, so we have Augur, Serum Visions, Cascade Bluffs. Probably can't play Kargon Dragonlord. Raging Ravine is also actually quite good, but that one might wheel. Let's see, how many spells do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 so far. So Augur would be pretty on in our deck. I think I'm more inclined to take the Serum Visions, though. It's just a consistency thing. Like, Serum Visions is always going to do what we're looking to do with it and help us find our powerful cards. Alright, so we have Mystic Gate, which would help us with our Stoneforge Mystic, although At this point, we'd only have one pack to try and get equipment to go with it, so I'm less excited about that. Negate is also fine. Grim Lavamancers would probably be pretty good in this deck. We have, you know, a lot of cantrips and stuff like that, but the card I want to take is Vidalkin Shackles. Right now, we just have sort of a smattering of red and green cards, just a small splash, and we can probably easily fit at least 9 islands in our deck, which would, well, maybe only 8, but still, you only need like 2 or 3 in play to really make Vidalkin Shackles a huge beating. So here we have Electrolyze, which I think is going to wheel again by the same logic that we wheeled the Izzet Charm, although there will only be 2 cards left in this pack when it comes back, so it could be like Nature's Claim and Electrolyze maybe, but I want to take the Underground Sea because it's a fetchable island with our Bloodstained Mire, which would so basically turn this into a Scalding Tarn for us. So that's what I'm going to grab. Alright, so we have Dismiss, which is, I think, just going to be a little too expensive. And Delver is the card that I'm interested in taking. We have 4, 5, 6, 7. Like, it doesn't play great with Wildfire or Rolling Earthquake, but we don't have to play Wildfire. And just playing a turn 1 Delver and flipping it is so absurdly good that I think it's worth taking. Alright. I like Crumbling Necropolis and Seagate Oracle both pretty well. I think I'm going to take the Seagate Oracle. I think our mana is going to be pretty reasonably good. So I don't think we need the Necropolis. And Looter, I think, is just a little worse than Seagate Oracle because it doesn't block. I'm going to grab Glacial Fortress here. Although Avalanche Riders is now starting to look slightly appealing with the Delver in our deck. I think the off chance that we end up with an equipment is worth it. Is more worth, like, I think we'd rather be able to play that than be able to play some random equipment. Or be able to play some random Avalanche Riders that is basically replaceable with any other 4-drop. Essence Scatter will easily make the cut. So is it Boilerworks versus Faithless Looting? And we have a total of 17 playables right now. We could also maybe splash this Absorb. That may be a little too deep. I think I'm just going to take the Fixer. Faithless Looting is okay, but we have Izzet Charm to get that same sort of effect. Alright, Cascade Bluffs came back. Perfect. Negate will also be fine. Can't complain about that. I'm not sure if Negate is like a main deck card in this cube still. I don't think it is, but I'd rather. It's definitely a good option to have. Electrolyze did come back, so that's perfect. That card fits really well in our deck at this point. I like the looks of where we are. We are sort of an aggro control deck that can definitely play a long game with cards like Huntmaster, Cryptic, and Sphinx. Right now, I think I'd rather not play the Wildfire, but other than that, the deck looks great.